you so much. Very happy to be here tonight. Thank you for letting us share some trumpet ensemble music tonight with you. These great students behind me have worked very hard and have really worked on some difficult repertoire, as you'll hear throughout the night. And I definitely want to thank them and appreciate all the hard work this semester. And so in case I forget to say that, I'm going to say it now. So that was Gabriele, one of the great pieces that Gabriele wrote for St. Mark's Basilica there in Venice. What's interesting about that is it had many different balconies in the church, and so you heard that idea of two different choirs back and forth, and that was very, very prominent in the music that Gabriele wrote. So I thought it would be a good way to start off our concert. And you notice that the title of our performance tonight is called Trumpets in Sound and Color. And so we have tried to put together some of the pieces tonight that will maybe elicit some idea of how the sounds of the trumpets and music affects different colors, how different colors affect different sounds. That's kind of what we were shooting for with this concert. So we'll talk a lot more about that, and some of the pieces will be a little bit more descriptive about that as we get later in the program. I'm going to move next to a piece called Festival of Lights. It's written by David Marlette. He is Canadian, trumpet player, cornet player himself, but a prolific arranger, in fact, even has his own publishing company. And he composed this piece called Festival of Lights. So I don't know if this is really going to sort of elicit any specific colors, but you'll hear maybe different sections that sound like maybe that kind of light, that kind of a light or something. We'll see. But I did want to tell you a little bit about what his thoughts were when he composed this. He says it's his way of paying homage to some of his favorite composers and some of his favorite compositions, such as those written by John Cheatham, John Barnes Chance, and the great Alfred Reed. So hopefully you'll enjoy Festival of Lights.
Thank you.
23 years ago, I guess in the year 2000, the International Trumpet Guild commissioned a very popular composer who writes a lot for brass. His name is Eric Ewazen, and they commissioned him to write a piece for trumpet ensemble. We have now the fruit of that composition and that commission called the Prelude and Fugue for Trumpet Choir. And so very fortunate to have enough students this semester to have two different trumpet choirs. And so Angelo State's colors are blue and gold, so we have one blue and one gold. And so we're going to play now with, you'll hear now our ensemble blue perform Eric Ewazen's Prelude and Fugue for trumpet choir. Very tough piece. You guys can admit. Entitled 7 for 5 because the piece is entirely in 7 beats per measure. And furthermore, those of you that may know a little bit about music or know about rhythms, each bar has 7 beats in it, and that is subdivided further into 2 7-8 bars. For those of you that don't know anything about music, that means it's very hard. It says it's about almost 7 minutes long, 6.5 to 7 minutes long, and he lists the difficulty as college level and higher. And the higher is probably where this piece falls. These guys have worked very hard, and within a couple of weeks, they're going to actually record this piece. And they're going to perform it from memory, not tonight, but for the recording, they will do it from memory and submit it for a couple of competitions that we have coming up in the trumpet world, one in March, one in June, in next summer. So in the next couple of weeks, they're going to be hitting it pretty hard. But I think you'll enjoy this performance already. So here we have 7 for 5 for Trey Harbold.
Thank you.
first one is just entitled Brooklyn Fanfare. Douglas Hedwig was a trumpet player, or is a trumpet player, and he was in the Metropolitan Opera Orchestra, and so his hometown of Brooklyn, New York, I guess, inspired him to write this fanfare. This is only four parts, and so you can see we're going to double or maybe even triple some of these parts, so it's a pretty exciting fanfare. Here's a taste of New York. Some music that he already had written. In fact, it's from his massive piece for orchestra called The Planets. He took music out of the Jupiter movement, and there's a beautiful hymn-like part of that movement, and he set that music to this poem, I Vow to Thee, My Country. So we'll just call this the Hymn from Jupiter by Gustav Holst. You'll hear a little bit of the mutes dropping. It is a trumpet concert. You'll hear a little bit of the opening of Jupiter, what the orchestra plays, but then we'll go right into the hymn. So, really interesting arrangement, again, done by David Marlott.
Thank you.
fanfare. This time we're sticking in London, we're staying in London. And Nigel Coombs was a member of the Irish Guards, trumpet player in the Irish Guards, and he wrote this piece, Trumpet Salutations. It's for six trumpets. It's a fairly short fanfare, but don't let it fool you. It's extremely difficult, and it hits some very, very interesting harmonies. So here is Trumpet Salutations. That may be interesting to you and may help you kind of think about where the main inspiration for this concert is. And it was the famous conductor, arranger, Leopold Stokowski, who said that a painter paints on canvas, but musicians paint on silence. And so it's in this next piece, it's going to be pretty interesting to see what this particular composer, Frederick Specht, thought about putting sound to silence. And it was the painter, from the late 1800s to the early 1900s, Vasily Kandinsky, also a Bauhaus master, that he considered certain sounds and he associated with certain sounds with certain instruments. He thought that the high trumpets to him meant sort of a lemon yellow color. And in shades of blue, he heard, when he heard the flutes, he thought of a light blue. When he heard the cello, he thought of a dark blue. The double bass was even a deeper blue, and a deep organ was very, very solemn and a very low blue. So he considered that, we have this idea of yellow and blue, and he considered them opposites, and that to sort of mitigate that and put something in the middle to sort of cool the conflict, he came up with red. And he thought that the red reminded him of certain fanfares, and then even a shade of red, vermilion, he thought of as the tuba. And then the Russian composer Alexander Scriabin, who lived up until 1915, suffered from synesthesia, which is those who associate colors with sound and sounds with colors. And so he thought that, for instance, the pitch D, if someone played a D, to him, that was a bright yellow. And if somebody played an A, it sounded like a dark green, or a D flat was a deep purple. And I even have this. I know it's hard to see, but this is a one octave keyboard. This is from the piano. And you can see what would normally be the white notes and the black notes. But this is what Scriabin thought of each. These are the colors that he associated with each one of those 12 notes. Pretty wild, isn't it? This sort of a pale blue is the letter is the pitch E, and it's almost a white. I'm not sure where he's coming up with that, but I don't know where he's coming up with any of this. But those are colors that meant something to him. And when he composed, he had this idea in his brain and in his ear. And that's what synesthesia does. So I wanted to read a little bit what the composer of this next piece, which is entitled Lumen, and wanted to read a little bit what he thought about this idea of sound and color. He says that this focuses on the color resonance and lyricism of the trumpet ensemble. The title, Lumen, which refers to the essential quality of light, is connected to this work as a metaphor for the diffusion of sound as light. So maybe you'll come up with your own idea, or your own colors and your own thoughts when you listen to this piece, Lumen by Frederick.
Thank you.
times during rehearsal, we would play and play, and I'd stop in the middle of the passage and I'd ask them, what colors are you hearing? And very interesting responses, and none of them were what I thought the color was. So to close out our concert, we have a piece called The Sound of Colors, and it was written by Demetrius Brown. And really a beautiful piece. It's very slow, but a lot of colors, a lot of beautiful harmonies. We're in for 8 different parts, and so we're going to double a couple of those parts. And see if you enjoy his idea of what he thinks colors sound like. This is his Sound of Colors, Demetrius Brown.
Thank you.
couldn't do a concert entitled The Sound of Colors and all that with the trumpets without doing something with a color in the title. And so we decided that we would do a little jazz piece, maybe. And so I arranged a version of Blue Bossa. It's a great standard written by Kenny Dorham. And it's going to feature all our guys, and you're going to hear four of us, actually four of them, are going to actually do some improvisation, play some jazz mix for you. So here is a bossa nova entitled Blue Bossa, and I got to get my, we're going to listen to a little backing track as well. So here we go, the Blue Bossa.